Okay, yes! Okay, so it's finally working. I'm here in RoPets. I'm going to take care of my pet needs pretty quickly. It's going to be a, I'm going to try to make it a small tutorial video. But let's see. So, as soon as you start, you kind of start, and it'll tell you to go see the mayor at the pet shop, which is down this big tree down there. And the mayor will give you a free egg. Okay, you have pet needs, which is these ones up here, and you can click them or tap them on your mobile, and they'll kind of give you a GPS to tell you where they, where you need to go. You can also kind of teleport, like after you get your egg, to certain places using your backpack. So you see all of them says get more, get more, get more. If it tells you the need for the vehicle, you can get more, of course. So for example, it says go to the pet shop. If I don't want to do that, let's just go to my pet paw here to get more. You kind of just teleport there. There are cute little NPCs around the map that will help you for around if you need any help, and they're kind of generated questions. So for example, the pet shop guide should tell you, if you have questions on my pet is dirty, why do some objects sparkle, which is kind of the next thing that I'm going to talk about. What is this place, which is the pet shop, and how do I ride a pet? So here she's going to kind of tell you, the objects that sparkle around the map contain coins, so you just tap them and your pet collects them for you, which is pretty cool. So for example, this one is sparkling. You just click it. And it gives you 10 coins. I remember I played this like 2 months after the game released, and this area wasn't here. And a lot of things has changed since then. But I recently just got in back to the game a few days ago, and it's so fun. Like, I've been playing for 3-4 hours at a time, and I've gotten a bunch of pets. Ooh, hold on. 6 months. Another bath. Did I give him a bath? I don't think I did. Let's go back in here. So the game is pretty fun. It's actually really, really, really fun. So there are mini games, not just with the rocks, the bushes, the traffic cones, the trash cans. You tap all of them and you get coins, and they kind of respawn or regenerate after a few minutes. Like, you can come back and you can tap them again and you can get 10 coins again, and it kind of adds up after a while, especially if you play for a long time. So let's go to one of these bushes so I can show you again, like, which one has some coins. So here are more NPCs. This is the evolution trainer, this is the trading guide, and this is the pet needs helper. Okay, none of these bushes are asking for coins. That's just completely fine. But sometimes right here, this little traffic cone will tell you to click it and you will get coins for it as well. And also, if you go inside this vehicle shop, also the traffic cones in here will tell you, that there's coins inside. So always, you know, wherever you are, just go and click it just in case. And this is the vehicle shop. This is where you can buy, like, vehicles. Some of them are with gems, which is the red gems. And these are a little bit harder to come by, but the game gives you many opportunities of getting some. You can either log in for 5 days or 6 days straight and you get 50 gems, or you can play the mini games. There's also an obby that you can play, and they also give you gems for that. So that's super exciting. There's many ways of earning coins and gems in this game. It's not like a one-sided thing or just only Robux thing. So I'm going to get into the car to kind of show you the mini game that I've been talking about. So this mini game right here is yellow and red circles. Well, yellow and pink circles. The yellow circles gives you 5 coins, and the pink circles gives you 5 gems. And of course, the pink circles are a lot more rare than the yellow ones. And they do respawn after a few minutes. So if you go and you're doing pet needs, you're doing obbies and stuff, they'll regenerate by the time you get back on a little car. Or if you want to spawn one of your own vehicles, same thing. Let's go here. Whoops. That was bad. Alright. And also, again, when you get the penny to go to the park, this is the park. And you can, again, check the rocks, check the bushes for some coins. Right here. Oh, look! I got a pink one. Okay. So, 5 gems. What else? Okay. So, now I'm going to talk to you about... I'm not taking care of my pet. I'm such a terrible pet trainer. Now we're going to talk about the obby. There are obbies that regenerate every 24 hours. And I did mines for today, so I won't be able to, like, collect anything. But for... it resets in 1 hour and 55. So in 2 hours. So this is today's course. I already did it. But every time you complete a stage, you get 40 coins. 40 coins, yes. And there's about 3 stages, I believe. Let me see. There's 1. Where's the second one? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so there's 4 stages and then there's the final stage. The final stage gives you also 10 red gems. And of course, like I said, they do regenerate after 24 hours. But if you keep getting on every day and you keep doing these like tasks and you keep taking care of your pet, all the coins and everything definitely do add up, because the pennies themselves, they kind of give you a lot of money. So you kind of have to know how to save. Hold on, I have to feed my pet. Where's my kitty cat? You have to learn how to like save and hold on. Okay, so you see this rock right here has regenerated again, and this one has too. So now I get to click them. So yeah, for the feeding or the eating need, the pet need, as you can see just now, I just got 100. So half of these things, they give you enough coins that you can buy food and you can buy your pet eggs. Let's talk about pet eggs real quick. I did not know anything about shinies or evolved pets, but apparently an evolved egg costs 900 gems, which I am saving up for at the moment. But they are super pretty. They have different colors, different names. They're very, very gorgeous. And then this is the regular pet egg here. It's 3,000 coins, and you kind of start off with 2,000 coins anyway, so you have to take care of your starter pet, of course, and you have to feed him and take care of him. And if you keep on clicking on stones and bushes, and you also do the obby, I am telling you, you reach those coins really fast. I thought I wasn't going to make it to buy a second egg, and I was really wrong. Like, I made the second egg, the money for the second egg in no time, and then the third egg, and then the fourth egg, and then the fifth egg. So it gets easy, and it's really fun. It's not like you're just waiting for a pet need to appear out of nowhere. You kind of always have something to do, so that's why it's always exciting. They do have pet wear. Here, there's a blue cap. It's the only one I was able to buy at the time. I do have more money now, but I'm waiting because there's going to be an update soon for houses. And this, age up. Oh, yes. Okay, so there's going to be a new update for houses. And then there's going to be a new sheet that's coming along with the update. So, of course, I'm going to buy eggs for that. I don't know how lucky I will be to actually get it. But, you know, it's okay. And now, I'm going to talk about aging your pet. Every time you age your pet, you also get coins. Hey, wait a minute. No, don't go to sleep. Okay, so every time you age your pet, you get coins. you get coins until they're tweens. Once they hit tweens, you start getting gems. So right now I got 100 coins from just taking care of my pets. And then when he gets into tween, you get 5 coins, I believe. Yes, it's about 5 or 10 coins. And then when you grow him up, same thing. So here are the little mini game circles, which is, you know, pretty fun. So this is what I'm talking about. You always have something to do. It's not just, oh, I get to age up my pet and you don't get any benefit. You do get a benefit. Every time he ages up, you get coins, you get gems. So there's always a benefit to both. Like, you're not just getting coins all the time. So that is always a really fun thing to have in a game. It's not just all Robux. Of course, if you do want to get ahead and you want to get more coins, you can go ahead and even buy coins with gems. If you have 50 extra gems but you need coins for the eggs, you can go ahead and do that. And then if you want to buy the red gems for the eggs, because it might be easier than just evolving the pets on your own, you can do that with Robux. So for evolve, I haven't fed him. Hold on. To make an evolved pet yourself without using your red gems, you need 4 pets of the same kind. So I would need 4 cats, and all 4 cats would have to be roe grown. So let me show you what roe grown looks like. So this is like full grown roe grown, and all of my pets right now are roe grown, and you need 4 of the same type. So I have 2 alpacas, I can't do anything with them right now. I have 2 elephants, can't do anything with them right now. 1 cat and 1 dolphin and 1 turtle. But that is not all. As you can see, there will be another update. This is super exciting. I don't know why it's lagging right now. Usually it doesn't lag. It's probably because I'm recording. I'm not sure how that works. But it's kind of lagging right now. Usually the gameplay is not laggy at all and you can just have fun. You can stop here and look at all the rocks to see. But yes, if you do take the time and you're just playing, you're taking care of your pet and you grind, that's basically what it is. If you grind in the game while you play, even for 30 minutes a day, you definitely get the full experience and you definitely get all the tokens you need. Also, the login rewards are pretty good. I think on the 4th day or on the 5th day, no, on the 4th day, you get 1,000 coins just for logging in. So definitely do that. And it's every 15 hours, I believe. So, you know, every day you log in, you can get your awards. Then the last day, which is the 5th day, you get 50 gems, which is also really helpful. If you're saving up, like me, if you're saving up for the red gems, you can buy vehicles with red gems, you can buy coins with red gems, you can also wait, save, buy an evolved egg. Either way, I'm still going to be buying pet eggs and saving up, because, you know, why not? The evolved egg is just the easy way of getting it. Of course, it's going to take a lot longer if you're saving up for it, of making an evolved pet. And they're randomized, so it's not like once you have all 4 of your pets, I'm pretty sure it's a randomized kind of thing. You can't choose the kind of evolved pet you want, but there's different rarities, which is pretty cool. Let me go in here. Yes, my cat. I haven't named my cat yet. So that's pretty much it. Let me see if there's anything else I need to talk about. This is a sticker book. It's not much I need to say about a sticker book. It's obviously the pets that you have, the evolved ones you have. So apparently, as you can see, there are 5 different types of evolved elephants, 5 different types of evolved ducks, 5 different types of dolphins. So that's gonna take a while to collect all. But if you play, like, if you play a lot, I know there's people that play for hours at a time, and this is a game you want to get into. You should definitely get into if you're like a pet collector, you like taking care of pets and stuff. This is definitely a fun game to get behind. Like, I usually play Dot Me, I play Overlook Bay. This one just it gives me, I spend a lot more time here recently than I have in the other games. So yes, here's the mini game again. As I've said before, they do respawn and they are a great source of like income. Ooh, I am so sorry. I did not mean to do that. Oh no. I'm so sorry. So yeah, you know, there's always fun things to do. Right now I'm at 9,000 tokens. It took a while. I think it took about 2-3 days. Yeah. The first 2-3 days I started playing again, I was on for 3 hours a day. And I would log in and log off, log in and log off. And it was pretty good. Alright, so the hot spring is over here. And that is all for this video.